running. Texans head coach Bill O'Brien preached to his team this week. This is the playoffs. You can't just dip your toe in the water. You have to be aggressive to stop Hilton, stop Ebron, stop Luck. Here was Steve Young and Lewis Riddick. That was clearly not the case early on. So, Lewis, what were the Colts doing so well?
Well, first and foremost, look, we talked about in pregame, they needed to protect the passer. They protected Andrew Luck. And then from there, everything else just kind of started rolling as far as the passing game and the running game. We knew that T.Y. Hilton was going to be a focal point. Here you see him at number three in the slot. You know they had to reroute him. They tried to get a bump on him, but then against his zone coverage, they get him matched up one-on-one right down the seam against cover two on the linebacker, and Andrew just lays a perfect ball in there with perfect protection. Here down inside the 10-yard line, it's man-to-man coverage. What are they going to do? They're going to run a little bit of a rub route, a little pick situation here, and really they get Ebron open to the flat here, and Tyrann Mathieu can't get to him. And then the run game was going to, and look, just watch Quentin Nelson here. Watch these guys go to work as far as at the point of attack. You're just going to see Texans bodies with their feet up in the air on the ground because people are just getting mowed down. This is a football team that's right now getting beaten from a physical standpoint, that being the Texans. And look, everything that Chris Ballard tried to do as far as how he built this football team from a physical perspective, it's all working.
You know what? This is a clinic. This is Sean Payton and Drew Brees. This is a play caller that is pressure testing every part of a defense, sideline to sideline, short. Every play has a reason. And then you've got the ultra guy that orchestrated to do it. Every time he runs a play, you think you get the most out of it. Andrew Luck is back. He is healthy. He looks like an all-pro, Hall of Fame kind of player. And with this combination with this coach, this is a love affair that is burgeoning. And to me, this is not about the Houston Texans. We can talk about what's wrong. This is about how good this team is. So, the offense, defense, to me, it's very exciting to see where the Colts are. Nobody wants to play the Colts right now.
Yeah, and Deshaun Watson didn't come in with any false expectation. The NFL playoffs, he knew it was going to be the hardest thing he ever did. But looking ahead to the second half, what can he do to get on track?
You know, one of the things about this Colts defense, they are efficient and disciplined. And you do not get them out of space. You've got to stop throwing the Hail Marys. You're going to have to respond with efficiency and discipline. If it's going to go anywhere in the second half, it can't be just trying to make it all up at one play. Go ahead and just get into some long drives. And Deshaun Watson needs to be, you know, 22 of 24 in the second half.
You said it. Luck, pain-free. He must use the word fun a dozen times when we talked to him. This is what fun looks like. 1,000 passing yards against the Texans this season. Only three quarterbacks have ever done that in a single season against the same team. One of them is standing right here.